NFP today shocked the markets and caused some serious volatility. You came here for some top trading setups, and that's exactly what we're going to look at. Post-NFP trading setups today, talking mostly about USD pairs, but some other ones that also creep in here. We're going to talk about gold, we're going to talk about some USD pairs, and maybe even some yen pairs, so let's look at some now. Welcome back to the channel, guys. If you're enjoying my content, if you're watching this every day, do me a favor, subscribe to the channel and hit that like button. It's free to do, takes like 2 seconds, and it really supports what we're trying to do here. Now, what we're looking at is the US dollar on the currency index DXY. What this does is it shows us the US dollar crossed against several other currencies at the same time. You've got the euro mixed in there, you've got the dollar against the yen, the Aussie, etc. And what this is showing us today is that we highlighted this actually on stream. We're looking at a 4-hour view right now, and you can see that we had in going into the news, which by the way was about an hour ago when I'm filming this now, you can see that we had a major drop all of a sudden here due to the news event, which we should actually go look at the numbers just to talk about this because it actually has some huge implications on the dollar. And it's a little bit confusing today because we had a little bit of mixed sentiment. So check this out here. Here's the numbers that we had come into the markets. We had 199K employment change numbers. Apparently, you know, the forecast was 426K, which is a big kind of miss there, which is probably causing a little bit of concern for the dollar. But also we had some positive numbers, which makes things especially confusing when we forecasted 4.1% unemployment, but unemployment rate was lower than expected. That's a good thing, right? So you had some good news and you had some bad news. Why is the dollar then down today big? Well, again, that's what we're here to talk about, and we're talking about setups going into next week because it is Friday, so the markets are closing. But there are some ideas here that I think we could really seriously find some great opportunities to buy these pullbacks on the dollar. That's my opinion. Let's look at this. So the dollar's selling off. Why is this happening? Well, here's one possible reasoning behind this. Although unemployment rate is down, which is great for the U.S., right? That's great. Unemployment rate going down is good. The employment figures being less than expected by a good margin is a little bit concerning. We have a lot of capable, you know, people who are choosing not to go back to work. In fact, a lot of people who are in the work range, right, before that 65 years old, that are choosing not to go back to work, which is causing a little bit of pressure on the inflation situation as newer workers are demanding higher pay and their output is not as good as some of the senior executives who are not coming back. All that stuff is big economic, you know, forecasting stuff that is a little bit beyond my paycheck, to be honest with you. But what I do know is that a lack of employment numbers is concerning enough to cause the dollar to come down. On top of that, there was a lot of optimism going into the US dollar today, which is a little bit not met, right? You can see the euro dollar here is rallying strong. Some of you guys have been seeing, if you've been watching the channel, you know I shorted the euro here and here, and I closed out of all my positions down here on the euro before the news event. And I'm really glad that I did because volatility did expand and we did see the dollar get very weak here today. Now, why am I still bullish on the dollar? Well, I think that although this is causing some volatility and some serious pullbacks, I think that the dollar is still strong overall. I think that the Fed's outlook of 3 rate hikes by the end of 2022 is very hawkish. And until that kind of goes away, until that idea or forecast is not there, I'm going to be bullish on the dollar until further notice. Of course, if I make any updates, you guys will probably hear about it on the channel, but let's talk about some individual currency pairs that look interesting post NFP. So Euro USD, maybe I can get a re-entry on this idea that I had up at this level here, right? I'm watching 1.134 and 1.135 as potential pullback areas for new sells, right? To basically re-enter my positions that I talked about previously. We didn't quite get the breakout that I was looking for. I was really kind of hoping that with strong US dollar news numbers, we could see a breakthrough structure and maybe even try and get through these lows. Doesn't seem like we're quite there yet, but I do still forecast or personally think that there's a high likelihood that we could see that here in 2022. For now, it does seem like we've found the bottom. So perhaps the best place for me to re-enter into my short thesis would be a pullback up to this area. So number one, going into next week, I'm watching Euro USD for possible shorts up in this area. Something like this, could give me an opportunity to try and re-enter that thesis that I had all of this week and last week, right? Where I took that profit off the euro dollar, and now possible pullbacks could come into play either today or going into next week. I like that idea for possible continuations. Next up, we're gonna take a look at a currency pair that my friend Ivan from the live stream today talked to us about, which is Aussie dollar, which actually looks very interesting. Today, let's look at the daily chart for just a second. We'll take a look at Aussie dollar here as price essentially tries to hold the low of this kind of counter trend. So check this out. So big trend to the downside, and we've seen this kind of impressive counter trend going on for the AUD USD currency pair. Now we're testing the lows here and trying to essentially hold this. You can see bulls on the Aussie are trying to hold the lows as we hit this 71.50 level. Now, if this were to have broken, I probably would have been looking all day at retests, but it does seem like we tried to get lower. If you're very aggressive and very bearish on this pair, perhaps there's an idea of shorting here with a stop somewhere above structure. I don't think it's the worst idea in the world because I am bearish on this pair for the time being. You know, I'm cautiously bearish though, because we are still, in my view, in a risk on environment overall, despite stocks coming down recently. I still like the idea of, some upside for risk on currency. So this is not my favorite setup, but I do like Aussie dollar for possible pullback plays, maybe going into next week. So let's mark this just as a possible idea. We'll go ahead and put our fibs on there. And I do highlight, more interested than what I just mentioned down here, would be this area up here. This area, to be more specific, being that, let's mark it as 71.80, 71.90, this range right here. Pullback to that level next week, or maybe even today, could be an opportunity, in my view, to short the Aussie dollar for continuations lower, as I do think that at what we just talked about on that daily chart, right, that counter trend could ultimately break and give us some great risk to reward, something like, you know, selling this pullback with a stop loss above. I'm not super opposed to that. So that's what we'll look out for. By the way, you guys, if I do take any trades, I will share them within the private Discord. Let me see if I can pull this up for you so you can see. So every trade that I take, I share within our private Discord. And by the way, we're doing 22% off. There's a 22% off sale in the description down below. If you punch in that promo code when you check out, you'll actually get into the Discord. There's a one-off choice that you can do, like the one-time fee, like you don't have to pay monthlies or anything like that. It's the gold membership option. And if you punch in the code there, I believe it is YTVIP. If you punch that in, you actually get 22% off of any of our memberships available right now for the new year. That's limited for a limited time, but we're looking for more traders, more serious traders to come join us. So within the group, you get to see all the trades that I'm taking, the reasoning behind them. So it's not just a blind signal service. The idea is, you know, with every trade, you know, for example, if I write out my thesis on the euro with every trade, the fundamental side of it, the technical reasoning, why my stop loss is where it's at, you know, everything about the trade. My goal is not just to provide like blind signals or anything like that. You get to see every trade that I'm taking and why. You can also see my other top traders there that we've got contributing to the group, Patrick, Enny, and also Ivan from the live stream earlier, does coaching calls throughout the week to answer questions, etc. So if you'd like to join, the link is down below in the description. We'd love to meet some of you guys. You can also join the chat room and meet some of us from around the world and jump in on the conversation. So again, these are things that I'm kind of like tentatively looking at. I did mention that I am looking at some yen pairs, and dollar yen looks very interesting to me for a possible pickup at the 50% retracement. It has been bouncing off this level and kind of consolidating. We did not get any explosive upside on the dollar yen, which I thought could possibly happen. Another conservative way to approach this would be to, is this going to give us what we want? Yeah, it kind of does. So we kind of have this like higher time frame flag. If you're more of like a momentum slash breakout trader, what you could look for is, you know, some sort of higher low and a breakout concept here on the dollar yen. That might actually be a play to look out for next week. If you're kind of like the sort of person who wants to wait for that momentum to pick up before jumping into trades. But for me, just my style of trading, I do like to just pick up pullbacks in an uptrend with a fundamental idea behind it, which for me, dollar yen longs still look opportune. And I think, you know, pullbacks to this level, I like it a lot. So I'm looking closely at that today with some dollar weakness brought on by the news. This is kind of how I use news, by the way. Big NFP release, lots of volatility. can sometimes provide me with the pullback setups that I'm looking for, right? Weakness on a pair that I like to buy could give me pullback opportunities. That's what I need to get in, is I need a discount, I need a little bit of uncertainty with the market in order to pick up my positions. In fact, this is getting real close to a level of interest for me. So let me just pull back, put my fibs back on here. And what we can take a look at is wherever that, let's see if I can get this to work. There we go. The 50% may look interesting. So we're getting awfully close. We're probably, I don't know, a couple pips away there on dollar yen for possible buys. I'll keep an eye on that one. I may not pick that up one before the weekend. I may look to do that in the new week. But again, if I take any trades, you guys will see it within the Discord. Those of you guys who are already members, just keep tabs on the FX trade alerts there on my trades there, and you'll see them there. By the way, we did actually add crypto and stocks. So if you guys are interested in trading stocks, Patrick and Annie, both are, Annie is more of a crypto trader and Patrick is kind of both. So we have tons of market updates coming out now because we have three people contributing. So no shortage of ideas, that's for sure. let's take a look at gold here together. So gold is kind of a mixed one. We did see a big shoot to the downside, kind of a fake out move though. I mean, look at this candle, you guys. This candle is crazy. It just went, it just went all over the place, right? That one candle right there, that is pretty much the epitome of a crazy NFP release. So we saw gold kind of make an initial move up, what actually happened, and then it dropped like crazy, and now it's kind of trying to poke back up. The thing I would say is, if you're watching gold from a lower time frame perspective, watch for some kind of breakout of this kind of consolidation range that we've been seeing, something like a breakout above the highs or above the lows, and a solid close, right? Because we saw gold try to break out, but it was not able to sustain any of those moves, right? We never saw a close outside of these ranges. We never saw like strength that stuck around. We just saw these spikes that kind of erased themselves very quickly. So be very cautious with that. But I would say if you're a gold bull, there may be some interest in this area. I mean, you do kind of have a pullback zone that is pretty, like there's a lot of bullish, that's why we got marked in green, is there's been a lot of bulls here recently. So if you are bullish on gold, keep tabs on 1790 for a possible move back above that 1800. I think that, you know, that's a big psychological level. Gold, you know, if people see it kind of going back up into the 1800s, if they can clear this level, you know, that could be a bullish thing. But right now, it's still struggling to get off these lows. And until it does make a decision here, gold is kind of just like a choppy, going nowhere kind of asset for me right now. But that's kind of my focus. So going into next week, I'm still dollar bullish, looking for pullbacks here off of this news and really starting to see some things set up. So of course, if you're not already in the group, use that 22% off sale. The link is down below in the description. We'd love to meet some of you guys and have you join our trading community. We're looking for serious traders who are ready to work and ready to contribute to what we have here in the community. So hope to meet some of you guys in there. Thank you very much for watching. See you next time. What's up, guys? Thanks for watching today's video. There are more videos available on our channel here and here, so go ahead and click into that for some more free trading content. With that said, thanks for watching. We'll see you back next time.